Game of Thrones.
Oh, no.
Oh, okay.
Don't even know. probably be problem.
Oh, no, we put it in on the
I just used my jacket. Right? Yeah.
Testing. Good morning, everyone. all be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here on this beautiful day to witness the union of Emery and William in holy matrimony. This is a day of great celebration and reverence on which we come together to recognize and to commemorate the sacred love and dedication shared between these two people. It is so wonderful to have you family and friends join us today. And the bride and groom would like to thank each of you for being here today and would like you to know that you are here because you play such a very important part in the intertwining of their lives. Now, who gives this beautiful bride to be married today? Very well, thank you, sir. You may take your bride's hand. I believe that the greatest of joys in this life is the conviction that we are loved and loved for simply being ourselves. And if there is anything better than being loved, is loving another with that same conviction. And this morning, we are here to celebrate and to proclaim a love just like that. This is the union of two individuals, hearts, bodies, mind, and spirit. Therefore, we know that marriage is not to be entered into lightly, but honestly, reverently, and deliberately. And it is into this union that you two are joined here today. You two stand here ready to embark on one of the greatest journeys of your lives. And you are so honored to share this experience with those that are gathered here to support you today. So I have a poem that reminded me of you two and your beautiful love story. And it says, whether you know it or not, it was always you two. It was always you two. It's always been. From the very first moment that you took each other in, you were searching for the one that your heart knew. And every day I know Will is grateful that he found you. You believe in love. You knew you were fated. And it's a remarkable bond that you two have created. And there is nothing that could ever keep you apart because your hearts will forever search for one another's hearts. Because it was always you two, and it always will be. No one could love each other so perfectly. You will always be the only one, indeed. And today we take what was always meant to be and unite you two beautiful souls in marriage. So a cafe in Asheville is where this love story begins, right? A first date that lasted for 4 hours, and a second date that lasted 6 hours. And we know that nothing happens by chance or by coincidence, and you two meeting was on purpose and with great purpose. And that meeting has led us to this place, this moment in time, where you two will share vows with one another that will last well beyond today, that will last well beyond this wedding, but for a lifetime. Emery, you told me that you fell in love with Will for his good looks. But most importantly, the genuine connection that you two share. You support one another. You laugh together. You enjoy each other's company. And every single day, you have no other person that you would rather be around. I dare to say that today, you two are marrying your very best friend. And that is why you enjoy doing any and everything together, from being the self-proclaimed nerds that you are, to enjoying gaming and watching shows, to cosplay and hiking. To be honest, it simply doesn't matter what you two are doing, as long as you are doing it together. And that is what true love is about. And that is especially what marriage is about. So I'm glad that little cafe crossed your paths. And I am truly honored to unite you two in marriage on today. So as we come to these sacred words, your vows, I just want to remind you that saying these words are one thing, but there is nothing more special and sometimes more challenging than living out these words that you two will say today for the rest of your lives. So I'm going to start with you, Emery. You're just going to repeat after me, all right? And you're going to look him into those blue eyes. I, Emery, take you, William, for my lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or more richer, to love and to cherish, in good times and in bad, in sickness, and in health. I will love you. I will honor you all the days of my life, forever and beyond. This is my solemn vow. I, William, take you, Emery, Imari, to be my lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or more richer, to love and to cherish, in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, even through a pandemic. I will love you. I will honor you all the days of my life, forever and beyond. This is my solemn vow. All right. Now I just have a question that I want to ask you two. So the only legal part of a wedding is where you say the two words, which is I do. So if you're gonna run, you have nowhere to go. Imari, Sabrina, Rhyens, do you take William Joseph Kidd to be your lawfully wedded husband? By making this commitment, you are joining in the sacred covenant of marriage. Do you promise to honor him in love, to be sensitive to his every need, no matter how many they may be, to comfort him in all difficulty, and forsaken all others so long as you both shall live? Very well. Now, William Joseph Kidd, do you take Imari, Sabrina, Rhyens to be your lawfully wedded wife? By making this commitment, you are joining in the sacred covenant of marriage. Do you promise to honor her in love, to be sensitive to her every need, to comfort her in all difficulty, and forsaken all others so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Very well. May we have the rings, please? Oh, you have one job. You did it well. Thank you. You can pass the box back to him. All right, I want you to hold those rings up for just a second for all to see. Now, as you can see, a ring is formed by a circle, right? And a circle has no beginning and it has no end. And I believe from the very beginning of time, whether you two realize it or not, you are meant to stand in this very space, to share vows with one another that will last for forever. And that is what that ring represents. It represents forever. So I'm going to have you repeat after me, and I'm going to start with you, Mom. And you're going to place that ring on William's finger. I, Imari, give you, William, this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment. With this ring, all that is mine is now yours. With this ring, I be wed. Right.
I, William,
give you, Imari,
this ring.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
With this ring,
all that is mine
was already yours. With this ring, I be wed.
I be wed.
I be wed. Place it on her finger. And I'm going to have you join me. Now may those who wear these rings live in love all the days of their lives. Now may the love that brought you two together continue to grow and enrich your lives. And may you continue to meet with courage any problem that may arise to challenge you. And may your marriage always be one of love and trust. And may the happiness that you two share today with your family and with your friends become a living truth in your lives forevermore. So Imari and William, we have heard your promises to share your lives in marriage on today. We recognize and respect the agreement that you two have made here this day before each of us as witnesses. Therefore, in honesty and sincerity of what you have said and done here today, and by the power vested in me by the great state of North Carolina, it is my honor and delight to pronounce you two husband and wife. You may kiss your beautiful bride. All right, it is now my personal privilege and great joy to be the first one to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. thinking about who wants to be next. I want to thank you all so much for being here today. Thank you for sharing in their love. Thank you for sharing in their lives, and especially in their marriage. And I just ask for your continued support, just like this, for the rest of their lives. Thank you all so much.